synchronized skating has grassroots as precision team skating, which developed in Canada in the late 1970s. Synchronized skating has developed into an elite skating discipline, requiring high athleticism and skill to perform difficult footwork in unison with speed, power, grace, and transition complex formations like circles, lines, wheels, blocks, intersections, and lifts.
We'll be right back.
Synchronized skating has been reviewed for Olympic eligibility, but has not yet been fully considered. Why not? To be considered for Olympic inclusion, a sport has to have had a world championship for at least 10 years. The World Synchronized Skating Championships began in 2000, and so this requirement is satisfied. But the IOC continues to move slowly with its consideration of the addition of synchronized skating to the Olympic Winter Games. Adding synchro to the Olympics definitely will have costs, so you can guarantee that the IOC is carefully considering financial implications. With teams composed of up to 20 skaters, plus coaches, managers, trainers, judges, and other officials, offering accommodations to 10 to 15 teams would easily require space for an excess of 400 people in the Olympic Village. The ISU's president has said that these sheer numbers are a major complication blocking synchronized skating from getting to the Olympics.
I just think of the Summer Olympics when they have basketball teams, the volleyball teams, all the team sports there. How can they house them in the summer and not us in the winter?
We wouldn't have our rooms. We already knew that. 4 people per room. Or 6, depending if there's a pull or bend. We wouldn't be picky. Just get us in there. Get us in.
The IOC will carefully judge if there are enough countries with competitive teams to confirm world competition. Up to this point in time, the sport has been dominated by 5 countries: Finland, Sweden, Canada, the USA, and Russia, with Finland and Sweden winning every world championship except for in 2009 when Nexus from Canada took the title. However, the competitiveness of synchronized skating at the world level has improved enormously, with countries like Germany, France, Italy, and Japan showing great improvement and continuing to develop strong teams. International Olympic Committee has expressed that they will not accept synchronized skating as an Olympic event because it is co-ed. They believe teams with men hold an advantage. It has been speculated that if the International Skating Union was to ban men from competing in the sport, it would more easily become an Olympic event. The ISU doesn't want to unfairly exclude men from competing, so the ISU and the IOC are at a deadlock. Will synchro have to settle for only world championships if the ISU decides they cannot ban men from the sport, or should the IOC, the International Olympic Committee, overlook men's participation in the sport if the ISU can prove that men do not give their teams advantages, since a major goal of the sport is unison, and skaters often have to compromise to perform this way? Men on teams have not caused a problem at the world level, so why would it be a problem at the Olympic level. There is an undeniable lack of public knowledge about synchronized skating. Synchro skaters, coaches, and supporters are working hard worldwide to promote their sport. Supporters of synchronized skating began a campaign to get synchro into the Olympics, and it is growing fast. The Twitter handle, #WhyNotSynchro2018, has started something unstoppable with growing numbers of supporters worldwide. The campaign really exploded in late January of 2014 at the Mozart Cup,